There.
Hello everyone.
Hello,
my name everyone. Is, hi. My name is Alan Roford. I'm one of your hosts for 3L Television, and my lovely co-host Jenny Titan Thai. And we have honor today of one of the founders for the Asian World Film Festival, Mr. George Jojo Chiamtrol.
George,
yes,
not Mr. Please.
Hello,
call me George.
George.
Or Jojo.
Yeah, George. I love that name, George. Thưa quý vị, là hôm nay là 3L TV là có hân hạnh gặp được ông George Chiamtrol. Do I pronounce right?
Chiamtrol.
Yeah. And then ông là giám đốc điều hành và của cái hội lễ hội phim thế giới của người Á Châu, thưa quý vị, phải không? Cho nên dịch vậy không biết có đúng hay không, tại vì cái title của ông nó dài lắm, nhưng mà nói tóm lại thì ông là cái người promo phim Á Châu và những tài tử Á Châu.
Và trong đó thì cái hội phim này đó nó có tới 56 nước Á Châu lận.
Wow.
Mình tưởng là thường thường Á Châu mình nghe tới là Việt Nam, giống như là người Hoa, người Campuchia cái này nọ, nhưng mà thật sự Hoa bên Á Châu đó nó có tới 56 nước rồi.
Wow.
Trong cái hội phim này là một hội lớn nhất ở nước Mỹ và cả thế giới luôn, nói về cái hội phim của người Á Châu. So one of the film festival that George found is called the Asian World Film Festival. It's one of the largest film festivals in the world for Asian films, and it comprises of about 56 countries in Asia. So when we think of Asia, we just think about maybe China and you know, some country like Vietnam, Thailand, Malaysia. But you know, Asia has a huge community of films of Asia, of different countries that we haven't heard about, like Afghanistan and all those countries. Yeah, so George is going to share with you regarding the film festival. So first thing I want to ask George is, can you tell us a little bit about you, where were you born and things like that, and how would you, little time frame of you, how you become a director and also the founder for the Asian Film Festival?
Well, I was born in West Africa.
Wow.
I'm from third generation and originally from the Lebanon, but lived most of my life, I mean, first half of my life I lived in Europe. Then I moved here 30 years ago to California. So I like to believe that I'm a citizen of the universe. I love people, I love every country, attached to many, many countries to countries that you don't even hear about, you never heard about. Yeah, for example. So, I came to the movies, it's very simple. Since I was born, that's all I wanted to do. My father built cinema theater in Africa. We used to live in the bushes, literally in the bushes. No white people. We were the only white people in Niger. And my father was a peanut grower, so he had to be where his plantation might be. And at night, there's nothing, you know, it's just bushes. The village, and he said, you know, let me build the cinema for those people. So he built the cinema.
How did he even know about the cinema? Did he watch movies or?
Yeah, we all were, the family were all crazy, but this I'm talking now 1948.
Wow. After World War II.
Yeah, so he built the cinema, and in those days in Africa, all the cinemas were open air, so only shows at night.
Okay. Outdoors.
So my mother didn't have anything to do. So when I was born, she would take me to cinema at night, and she said the whole time your eyes would be on the screen. So I was born. I would say that's where my eyes were opened the first time. And I always wanted to be a movie maker. The rest is history.
So do you study in Africa or in America?
No. They took us. You know, in those days, a lot of the movies in West Africa, Nigeria, Niger, Benin, Togo. So the father would stay in Africa to work, and he would go Christmas, Easter, summer to Lebanon to see his family. So when I was 4 or 5 years old, my mother took us to Lebanon to go to school, because the bushes don't have schools.
Right.
So I went to Lebanon to school, and then at the age of 9, you know, in those days, the father, mother, they said, where can we put our son? We want him to have the best education in the world. But they don't think about the emotional repercussions. So they took me and dumped me literally in France. No family, nobody. No friends, no family, nobody. They put me in this very harsh private school in Normandy, where we were about 250 kids, and most of them were, you know, sons of presidents, kings, whatever. So that's the surrounding I was raised in. And I stayed there 7 years in that school. I finished. And every summer, every Christmas and Easter, I would go to Lebanon or to Africa for my vacation. So I would see my parents 4 months out of the year, that's it. So of course it was very tough. Emotionally, it was extremely difficult. But you know, your parents, in those days, they didn't think. They think, okay, I want to give them the best education in the world without thinking that there could be this emotional impact. I am grateful. So from there I went 1 year to Germany. From Germany I went to Wales, 2 years in college. From Wales I went to Poland. From Poland I went to Russia. From Russia I came back to Paris.
Almost all over Europe.
Yeah. And I graduated. Yeah, I did. I used to love to go behind the Iron Curtain, you know, when the countries were still colonies. And I had a great time. I loved the people. The people were very nice. Corruption did not exist like it is today. People were extremely educated, and life was easy behind the Iron Curtain. And I loved Poland. I loved every minute of it. And then came back to Paris, graduated, then went to Lebanon and started my movie career.
So what are all the different type of languages that you speak?
Well, at one point I spoke 9 languages.
Oh!
Wow, 9. Nói được cái 9 tiếng
là quý vị.
But the thing is, you have to understand is that when you don't speak the language sometimes, it goes away. But then it comes back when you go to a country, and then after maybe 72 hours, language comes. But what really helped me were the 7 years I learned Latin. Mm-hmm. Latin is the basis of
many languages. Yeah.
So that helped me. When I was in school, I hated Latin. I cursed every hour. But now I thank the Lord a million times. Thank you, God, for letting me have, because it was so easy to learn all those languages. The only non Latin language was Korean. I learned Korean. I went to school in LA. We're not going to see. He's doing it Lebanese way. This is the Lebanese way. Okay.
Xong rồi em để quên đó cho anh, tại anh đang quay phim. Cảm ơn em.
So yeah, sorry. So what I was saying, the only language which was non-Latin was the Korean language. So I can read, write Korean. If they speak slowly, I can understand about 60-70%.
No way. That's a lot. 60-70%.
Yeah, I do. I can follow a discussion. Absolutely. If they speak slowly.
Were your family generation, were they ever ambassadors of any kind of country?
No. My absolutely no. They all came from trade. They were traders. My mother's side, they were traders. My father's side, he was born in Brazil, he came to Africa and then went into peanut plantation. He was one of the biggest peanut growers in Africa.
Incredible. Because of the climate, hot climate is easy to grow.
Yeah. So I was born into peanuts, and when I see peanuts, I love peanuts. I'm a lover of peanuts.
We too. Now, let me ask you, what year did you come to the U.S.?
I came in 1989.
1989. And did you start your film career by then?
No. I started my film career, I was 20 years old.
Oh.
In 1966.
Oh my gosh. Back over in West Africa?
Paris. I started in Paris, graduated in Paris, went to Lebanon, and I shot my first movie in Lebanon in 1968.
So far from then until now, how many films have you completed?
Well, I mean, okay, if you go to IMDb, you probably see about a dozen, but don't forget that the 60s, 70s.
There's no record, right?
Yeah, they don't have them, and I don't have time to do it. It's a lot of work. I would say I have about 40.
Incredible.
Directing, producing. Yeah, I have about 40.
Đạo diễn George Cho Cham Song đã làm hơn 40 phim rồi các bạn ơi.
Rất là hay luôn. We might need your help in the future.
So I know that you found, co-found the Asian Film Festival, which is the Asian World Film Festival, which is one of the publication here every year that he does it. So what year did you start it, and what inspire you to do this?
2015. This is our seventh year. The inspiration was extremely simple, actually. There was a lack of attention to the Asian cinema, and every year, you know, at the Oscars, you know, they would, a lot of movies would go unnoticed, especially, you know, in the 90s, Korean movies were like top, the best movies, better than any American movie, or any French or European movie, and they were totally disregarded. And in 2015, I calculated that in 73 years of Oscars, only 6 Asian movies won the Oscars. 6, can you imagine? In 73 years, that's less than 1, you know, 10 years. That's terrible. So, the Minister of Culture from Kyrgyzstan, Sadiq Shernyaz, came to me and said, we're friends. He had a movie in at the festival for the Oscar, not at the festival, sorry, at the Oscar, he had his movie. That was 2014. He came to me and said, Jordan, why is this happening? And he said, you know what? The only answer that comes to me is that, you know, the members of the ambassador, the Oscars, they love their comfort zone, which is understandable in a way. They mostly came from Europe. So where do they look? They look at European movies. And they forget that, you know, we have 53 countries in Asia.
Right.
That most of them, about 35 of them, they have a movie, you know, production. They have movies.
Right. Or unknown.
Yeah, because Asia, you know, is huge. You know, it starts from Cyprus, all the way to Japan, from Russia, by way of Georgia, Turkey, all the way down to Indonesia, China, India, 53 countries. So he looked at me and said, George, what can you do? What can you do? And I said, the best I can do is that I need, you know, organizing festivals. Let's organize a festival. But let's make it special. Let's just focus on Oscar and Golden Globe movies. That's what we did.
Thank you for that. From all the Asians, we want to thank you and your team for creating this amazing festival.
It's a passion.
Asian team,
it's our passion. We are all my whole team and myself, we are all volunteers. We don't get sent. And they've been with me, a lot of them have been with me for 7 years now.
Amazing.
And so, they were passionate.
Wonderful. So right now we're in September of 2021. Now I know that your seventh year is coming up in this November, correct?
Yeah, 5 weeks.
Yeah. So we're very excited to, you know, can't wait to see all the films that's going to be released during that time. Now, so what are your plans for the future of the Asian World Film Festival?
Well, actually, before I go into the future, this year we're very focusing on the Vietnamese.
Oh wow! Okay.
So this year there's a whole Vietnamese section, several movies, parties, etc., etc. Huge. We're doing something big.
Wow.
Vietnamese, and then this year also we opened up to Africa. So this would be the first year we show Oscar movies from Africa. So I mean, we have a lot of great events this year. And the future, well, the future will always be the same. We are here to cater to the Oscar and Golden Globe nominated movies, and we're very proud to say that in 7 years we have 2 Oscar winners. One of them is Parasite, which we were.
Oh, amazing! Yeah. I've seen it. Amazing.
And we were one of the official PRs. And Persian movie also won the Oscar, and we had several nominations. We're very proud. We want to believe that we did have a little bit of promotion, because our main goal is to promote those movies that are submitted to the Oscar.
Oh,
Help us in future, okay?
Now, George, I know one of your major sponsors is Vietnamese, the living legend artist, right? So Daniel Nguyen. Could you tell a little bit about what he sponsors and, you know?
Daniel is a blessing. I'm not kidding. He is a blessing. We met, and we met Kofuchi, who is one of our,
legendary
actress. Not only that, she's one of our biggest supporter of the festival. She introduced me to Sir Daniel, and then the rest was history. Within a month, he came to me and said, look, I can do this, and I did it. He really put the words where his mouth is, which is very rare. He brought me many great sponsors, and one of them is Michael Dow. He's my biggest sponsor.
Yeah, he's a friend of mine too.
Yeah. And not only he's one of my biggest sponsors, he also gave $10,000 for a movie. I don't know which movie will win, but the movie that wins gets that.
Really? That's amazing. Yeah.
So, and I have several Vietnamese, mostly the doctors actually, that stepped in and supported us. So Daniel made this happen. He just picked up the phone and said, hey, you have to do it. And they did it. No question asked.
Well, owning one of Daniel's pieces is an honor. Because those pieces, in the future, it's a great investment.
Yeah, of course.
Besides his painting or his sculpture art.
Yeah, what he did is he did 12 sculptures that he gave to AWFL. And the donors gave us for each of them. So yes, there's also Jonathan Bao and Philip Lam. They're incredible. Those people are amazing. I discovered an incredible community.
Because we're refugees, we're the same. Refugees, we left the country because of communism, communism controlling our country. That's why currently in America we have about 2.2 million Vietnamese. And right here, sitting in Orange County, we have over 500,000 already. So the community, the one thing that I like to see is the community more get together and really, lift up and drive the community even further than what it is now. Yeah. Now, what about you? What about your country, like Lebanon?
Deep. I don't want to say the word, but deep. When this country used to be at the forefront of everything, it was the most beautiful. It is still beautiful. But what the leaders did to this country is unacceptable and criminal. But also, I don't want to blame only our leaders, I want to blame us, the Lebanese. We don't have this nationalistic mind. We are people who love to dance, to party, to eat, and we don't think about that. Your country needs you, needs your help. This nationalistic fiber does not exist, and that's what led us to where we are today.
Maybe you could help change that with films and with festivals and with education.
I would love to, because it's very sad. Yeah, honestly, I don't know. I'm very sad because I love Lebanon. I go to Lebanon at least minimum 1 to 2 times a year. I still have homes there. All my childhood friends that I've known for 70 years are there. I love it. It's a country where you live, you have fun. Literally fun. When I say fun. You have the best restaurants, the best nightclubs. It's a laid back. Dolce Fagnetti. Don't laid back.
What about the freedom of speech or freedom to show films there? So have you brought the festival to the country?
I have a festival there actually that I work with. I have 2 festivals. Okay. And you, Dr. Daniel, mostly National Film Festival, small shorts. And we have the big Women Film Festival that we organize every year.
I think we were with the women, our donors, doing this festival. It's easy.
So yeah, I have 2 festivals. I'm on the board and I help them.
Well, you know, George is in his 70s already, and it's amazing you can't even tell that you're in 70s.
Why did you say that? What about the girlfriend?
Okay, here's the secret. George has a weakness. If you see both a beautiful woman, he just melts.
And I get younger.
Yes. Which is a good thing. So we want George to live longer so he can enjoy being a wonderful director for over 40 films, and we can't wait to see him directing more films and also helping younger directors to progress on their career as well. So Jenny and I are very proud to have you today to share your story about your life story. I know there's so many more things we can ask George today, but we'll keep that for the next episode. So thank you so much, everyone, for listening to the Real TV.
That's a long story from George. You need to translate that into Vietnamese because I have bad memory.
Oh.
Just summarize what he said, like where he came from.
Kính thưa quý vị, George thì hôm nay là George cũng đã 74 tuổi rồi, là một người đạo diễn rất là tài ba và đã làm hơn 40 cái phim. George thì sinh ra ở West Africa, là cái khu vực mà bên Phi Châu đó, Tây Phi đó. Thì gia đình của George từ hồi nhỏ thì George đã đi qua bên Europe rất là nhiều, là ở bên Pháp, bên Đức, bên Tây Ban Nha, rồi Ba Lan, rồi quay qua Nga nữa, nên học hỏi rất là nhiều về cái khu vực và phim ảnh về khu vực đó, rồi đã làm phim lúc mà từ khi mà George 20 tuổi làm cái phim đầu tiên, rồi bây giờ qua tới Mỹ thì cũng đã làm hơn khoảng 40 cái phim rồi. Thì trong cái hệ thống mà IMDb đó, là cái hệ thống lớn nhất trên thế giới về cho những người tài tử và những người mà làm nhiều phim ảnh đó, thì trong đó nó để chỉ mười mấy cái phim thôi, nhưng mà George là tại vì rất là bận, không có kịp thời gian mà để những cái phim cũ ngày xưa làm cái thời thập niên 60, 70, 80 trong cái hệ thống đó. Thì quý vị biết là năm nay đó là cái năm thứ 7 mà cái hội điện ảnh phim gọi là Asian World Film Festival đã thành lập được từ 2015. Thì năm nay là năm thứ 7, thì tháng 11, ngày 1 với tháng 11, ngày 17 năm nay đó thì sẽ là cái buổi film festival này. Thì kính mời quý vị lên tiểu bang Cali và tới thành phố Culver City ở trên quận LA để mình tìm hiểu về những cái phim mà đã được chiếu ở đây. Thì trong cái hội phim này đó thì nó có khoảng 53 cái nước ở bên Á Châu. Thì 53 nước này đó là có nhiều cái nước mà quý vị cũng chưa có nghe đến, giống như cái nước Azerbaijan hay là những cái nước khác ở bên đó. Thì những cái nước đó là họ có những người đạo diễn và những cái phim ảnh và những cái lịch sử phim về những cái nước đó mà mình chưa kịp, mình có thời gian để mình tìm hiểu, để coi. Thì quý vị hãy vào cái film festival này và để coi, để tìm hiểu thêm. Trong cái website này, the website is asianfilmfestival.com, right? asianworldfilmfestival.org. Vâng, xin cảm ơn quý vị đã theo dõi chương trình của Real TV và Alan và Jenny với lại nhà đạo diễn Giorgio Champion hôm nay để chia sẻ thêm về cái hội điện ảnh phim và cái cuộc đời của đạo diễn này. Xin cảm ơn quý vị.
So the festival is November 1 to 11.
Yes. Đạo diễn mới nhắc lại là tháng 11 ngày 1 chứ tháng 11 ngày 11 này là cái ngày có phim, cái phim festival này. Cái ngày thường thường đó, những cái hội phim điện ảnh á, cái ngày đầu tiên là gọi là grand, là cái opening night, là cái ngày quan trọng thứ nhất. Rồi cái ngày quan trọng thứ nhì đó là cái ngày closing night. Hai cái ngày đó rất là quan trọng, nhưng mà trong những cái buổi đó chiếu đó cũng rất là quan trọng, tại vì những cái phim được chọn lựa rất là kỹ càng để được chiếu trong đó. Giống như hội phim, mình nói về cái hội phim của Sundance, là một cái hội phim lớn nhất ở nước Mỹ đi, thì mỗi năm đó nó có khoảng 9.000 cái phim nó làm, nó gửi vô khoảng chắc 3.000 tới 4.000 cái phim. Thì trong 3.000, 4.000 phim đó nó chỉ chọn khoảng 100 cái phim thôi để nó chiếu. Thì quý vị thấy là cái cơ hội mà để vô cái phim nó rất là khó, và đồng thời vô được cái hội điện ảnh đó rồi đó, để coi phim đó thì họ phải chọn lựa cái phim nào giống như tài tử hay nhất, phim hay nhất, hay là cái màn ảnh hay nhất, hay là cái gì đó. Thì đó là những cái mà họ sẽ chọn lựa và cho những cái giải. Thì năm nay đặc biệt đó là có cái sự bảo trợ của một cái nhà họa sĩ rất là nổi tiếng của người Việt mình, tên là Sir Daniel Wynn. Là anh chàng này là có một cái gallery, có hai cái gallery ở Beverly Hills tuyệt vời đẹp. Ngoài ra một họa sĩ đó, anh chàng cũng là một cái người mà phải nói là nắng tượng rất là đẹp. Thì năm nay đó Sir Daniel Wynn đã nắng vài cái tượng để cho những cái giải thưởng thanh năm nay, và đồng thời đã đem kêu gọi vô những nhà bác sĩ giống như là bác sĩ Michael Dow hoặc là những nhà bác sĩ khác để họ hợp tác để cho những cái giải cho những cái người mà trúng giải trong cái phim năm nay. Nên nếu mà được thì mời quý vị đến tham dự ở đông đảo năm nay để mình có thể coi, tìm hiểu thêm về cái hội phim này.
Cũng chỉ xin nói thêm là cái khuynh hướng bây giờ đó là phim Á Châu, mà đặc biệt năm nay là cái hội phim này họ tập trung lên cái phim của người Việt Nam chúng ta, cho nên đây là cái cơ hội để chúng ta tỏa sáng thưa quý vị. Hy vọng là sắp tới Oscar sẽ có phim của Việt Nam đi dự, không biết thắng hay không, nhưng mà thôi kể, Golden Globe thì mình cũng được nominate cũng là vui rồi. Thì tại ông nói là nhờ ông cũng để ý tới những phim Á Châu, cho nên chúng ta mới có cái phim Parasite của Hàn Quốc đã được giải Oscar năm rồi đó, là đó là cái mở màn thưa quý vị. Tại ông nói là trong 73 năm giải Oscar chỉ có vài phim Á Châu, và chỉ có 6 giải của người Á Châu thôi, cho nên là bây giờ chúng ta sẽ mở ra một cái thế hệ mới, người Á Châu của mình sẽ có nhiều Oscar hơn và Golden Globe.
Xin cảm ơn, xin chào quý vị.
See you at the festival.
Yeah, see you. Yeah, I will convince my dog.